part.
We got to record this. It's too good.
You have your grandbabies jumping all over the place, and you're jumping right along with the grandbabies. And I mean, you have how many grandbabies? One grandbaby?
This is my first. Or you're listening? This is my first.
Oh, so imagine if you have three and four of them. How are you going to be able to jump with them? So imagine yourself jumping all over with them.
Make it more romantic. Somebody else said, you're walking on the beach, but you're showing your friends. You're holding hands with the little one at the beach. You're putting him or her on your shoulders at the first birthday party. When you come over, she goes, Grandpa, and gives you a big hug. You know, I could make it. What happens when you make a picture in their mind that emotional? What happens?
Yes, they get into it. They want it.
Oh yeah, and then you say the magic, 1, 2, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 words.
I've made a decision, Claude. You're going to enjoy the grandbabies. You're going to enjoy your wife again and your family and your health again. Here's my prescription.
Boom, closed.
Get down today.
This is it. So you see, did we talk about features and benefits and all the medical terminology and everything? Or did we just talk to a man who wants to see his first granddaughter?
We talked about a different kind of benefit and a different kind of that is more important than the actual benefits of other stuff. Yeah, the emotions.
You close them emotionally right in the beginning. You get them to make a decision right in the beginning. You solidify, you get a commitment, a full commitment after the fact. Once you get the decision and the emotion, then you give the facts and figures and you close. And then sooner or later, you've got to go to the technical stuff, mm-hmm. but you win them. And most people do it the opposite way. Mm-hmm. They do a little, they're still teaching like it's 1960. They're still doing a little, the rapport and the bonding and the jokes, and they do all that stuff. Okay. But today we're in a different world, aren't we? Do people have the time? Do they want to mess around with all that stuff? Yeah. This is good stuff. So when you get them that emotional, that early, and you use assertiveness, you can close them in the very beginning. I have made a decision. This is stuff. And I tell people, I can close people in sometimes, not always. If it's emotional enough, if the money is there, if I have the decision maker, if it's timely, and I tell them, you know what, I've made a decision. We're just going to do this right now. I have made, think about it. The salesperson is saying this to the prospect. Mm. How powerful is that?
Mm-hmm. It is.
It's assertive, but it's assertive. The prospect doesn't take it as bullying or controlling. The prospect says, hey, this person cares about me enough to speak this way to me. Mm-hmm. That's powerful.
In the movies.
Yes. This is persuasion. This is persuasion to the 10th power. This is what top salespeople do right away. They skip all the la-di-da stuff. They get right. Maybe it's a New Yorker in me. Questions or role plays. Let's do something different. We got some time here.
Anybody 3 minute have? Qualification.
What about it?
A role play. I mean, that's one of my big problems. On and on and.
Yep.
The call takes way too long.
Right. What is the prospect? See, what we forget is the prospect has an agenda, has their own system. What is the prospect who's shopping around or is on a fact-finding mission? What is it they want to do with you in the beginning? If they don't know you. Yeah. They want to get a lot of information. They want to pick your brain. 21 questions, right? And if you're a salesperson who hasn't had enough, you haven't had enough conversations, enough meetings, enough sales. How do we act when we're desperate?
Oh, great. Have somebody to talk to.
Oh, yeah. Like a little dog begging at the table, right? Mm-hmm. Okay. We become do we start when we get emotionally involved and become desperate? I've been desperate. Oh shit, I need a sale. The rent is due. So I've been there. Mm-hmm. I got bills. I got credit card. I need a sale. When we become desperate and we act desperate, does the prospect pick up on it?
Oh yeah.
Yeah.
And how do they treat us when we're sending those signals?
Now they become dismissive. Yeah. They're like, no, I don't want it.
Maybe I don't. Or ask for a discount, you know.
Ask for a discount. Yeah. Oh, I don't need you. There's 20 other people I'll call. So how do they treat us? They treat us like shit.
Yeah.
Right? Would they treat their doctor, their lawyer, their minister, their father-in-law? Would they treat anybody they know or anybody who's a professional they respect would they treat anybody the way they treat you in a sales situation if you act submissive?
Mm-hmm. Treat us worse.
Yeah. So what's the role we need to play, Christian, when we're talking to somebody? What's the role? Yeah. What's a professional? What's a success? What's a successful, busy professional sound like? Hi, Christian. Claude Diamond here. I'm really interested in doing a deal with you. I just have a bunch of questions. I got your name from Yiming.
Sure, Claude. We can answer the question. What do you want to achieve today?
I want to invest in real estate. I just went to the Joe Blow seminar. I walked on hot coals and everything like that. And I got your name from somebody. And you live close to me. And I heard you're the guy to talk to about a real estate and stuff. And
that's great.
Like contracts. Where do I get contracts from and stuff like that?
Claude, I mean, we could definitely get you contracts. I mean, my question for you is, why did you come to me if Joe Blow was providing you all that information?
Well, Joe Blow's new in the business and everything, and he gave me a card. So, and he said you live near me, so I thought I'd just call you and pick your brain a little bit.
Yeah, great. Claude, I can definitely give you some information. I mean, if we can get you the information we need and get you invested in that real estate that you want to do, I mean, I am kind of expensive and I have limited time. I mean, are you able to make a financial commitment?
Yeah, for the right person, but how do I know I can trust you?
I mean, maybe you can, Claude. What about the people that referred you over to me? Do they trust me?
I don't know. I'm new. And like I said, I'm new in this bit. Okay. What's the off the role play? Okay. The reason I called you is I want to invest. I want to do real estate. I want to invest. I called you up because I want to pick your brain. And right away, I was very nice to you in the beginning. And then right away, I insulted you. How do I know I can trust you? How do I know this and that? You're going to let me get on. Would a guy with $5 million in his bank account, what would he say to a guy who said, Yiming, you got $5 million in your pocket right now. Your pockets, all of them, $5 million. And I go to, well, Yiming, I thought I'd call you up. I'm looking to invest in real estate. How do I know I can trust you? How do I know this is legit?
Well, Cloud, I don't know what to tell you. I got so busy. I got a lot of properties invested in my last decades. I have nest up of $5 million in my bank account. You don't have to. I mean, I to be honest, I don't want to waste my time, you know, either, if you don't think there's a good fit.
Always end in a question. Suzette, how do I know I can trust you?
Okay,
always end in a question.
Maybe you don't, Claude. I get a lot of clients and they pay me a lot of money. Okay. But how can you do business with me like my other clients? I don't know.
I'm new. I'm just learning. I want to invest in real estate. I got your card from somebody at the Firewalk seminar, and they said you're the woman who really knows real estate in Maryland. Is it Maryland?
Maryland, yeah.
Oh, I remembered. And everything. You've got to change my attitude right now.
Right.
I think I can bully you.
Right, right.
You've got Suzette, Yiming Christian, you have $5 million. How are you going to, you got $5 million tax-free in your bank account right now. Are you going to take any garbage from anybody?
No.
But how does that change? So let's play that role. When you're talking to somebody, what's the role you're going to play if you have that $5 million? Hey, man, I got money.
You know, being assertive.
Trust me. Listen, you came to me, buddy. I don't, you know, go away. I don't need you. I'm successful in my own right. I'm busy as hell. I'm not here to defend myself. You really just asked me that?
So that's what we think. What should we really say?
Actually, I think that's what you should say.
Oh, really?
And then turn chicken shit into, my mentor used to always say this, turn chicken shit into chicken salad. You got to put me in my place. First of all, I call you up. I want to pick your brain. I like, you've got nothing better to do. Oh, let me ask you all these questions. Then I go, how can I trust you? Or why should I work with you? What's wrong with my attitude about you right now? What's wrong? And you've got to fix that real fast. Why?
To gain the controls and also the credibility, you know, all that.
Right. Are these the kind of conversations we have with people where they get defensive or they attack us and everything? Why do they behave like that?
Past experiences.
Good. What else?
They're not showing probably the assertiveness that we should.
Maybe we're too nice.
Confident.
We're too nice. Yiming, what was the first role play we did where I asked you to change, where I told you I wanted to change the appointment. I wanted to see the
scarcity.
Scarcity. Mm-hmm. Scarcity is big. Social proof. Social authority. Proof. Yep. Is everybody here? Oh, I just happen to have, this is great. You know, I love when what is it called? When opportunity meets practicality. Look what's on my desk.
Ooh.
Okay. In most conversations, you will use the psychological triggers. I have them on my whiteboard here. Likeability and trust, scarcity, social proof, reciprocity, authority, commitment, consistency. All the important.
That's what I need to do. Put them in a whiteboard.
Yeah. Have you guys all, Tom, please say yes. Everybody's read this book or listened to it on YouTube. It's on YouTube also for free.
Oh.
Okay. Every conversation. Insurance. You're on a stage. You don't have a script. You're playing a role right now. Because you can't can you have a script for all the variables in sales?
No.
You've got to practice so much that it's spontaneous and that you play the role, mm-hmm. the right role at the right time. Mm-hmm. Sometimes you're empathetic, you're nurturing. Sometimes you have to be authoritative. Okay. You get that person picking your brain. Let's do that role play. Go ahead, Suzette. You want to pick my brain. Hello, Claude here.
Hi, Claude. I saw that you are very knowledgeable in real estate.
Thank you.
Yes, I have some questions here because I'm trying to start in the real estate and buy a couple houses. So what should I do first?
It's a great question. And can I get your name and phone number? Yada, yada. First, in case we get disconnected. Okay, great. And tell me, what would you, how are you and I going to do business today?
Well, if I like what you're telling me, I would like to hear more.
Okay, but are you prepared to make a commitment today? If you like what I say, if I can propose a transaction to you, that can make you money. Are you financially ready? Do you have the resources? And do you have the authority to make a commitment today?
You're hesitating. Money, you mean? Like make commitment?
Yeah. Well, what are we talking about? A cardboard box behind the Walmart or $1 million home here?
I don't know yet because this is my first time. So I'm trying to find out where should I start and what should I do. I don't have much money saved.
What's your resources? I hope you don't mind. Can I ask you a few quick questions? Because I want to get I just don't have the time. I've got a closing today. I've got 5 appointments. I'm taking my wife to the vineyard. I'm way too busy. But you sound like a nice young woman. I'd love to help you. Can I ask you 2-3 quick questions to get to the point?
So I got to pay you to talk to you? Is that what you're saying?
Did I ask for money?
No, but you asked me for a commitment.
And I asked you a question before and you still didn't answer it. You were obfuscated. Off the role play, I wouldn't say that part, but that, what did she do brilliantly before? What did Suzette just do? That prospects-
Got into the question.
You didn't answer my question, A, and then what did you do? Brilliantly, you did it really well. I almost didn't see it. You did it really well. Did you do that on purpose or just naturally or?
I guess that's natural.
Yeah. That's really naturally what happens too.
And that's actually what happened. We get emotionally involved. We ask a question. I'm being assertive, almost on a bull, almost bullying her, if you noticed. I'm being a little, because I'm busy. I've got appointments and everything. I'm using scarcity and everything. And I asked her a question, which she never answered. And then Suzette basically asked me a question. That's called an obfuscation. Okay. She took control from me, didn't she, by asking the question? So we've got a test of wills here. And in my mind, she didn't answer a direct question. What is your resources for liquidity and decision-making capability? She never answered that. What does that tell me in my mind right away?
I don't have any.
Yeah. It's a problem. Which means for me, what? Will I make money with Suzette today?
Probably not.
Probably not. So in less than 3 minutes, what did I learn?
Suspect.
It's a suspect. Mm-hmm. It's probably not a prospect, probably not. Probably someone who does not have the credit or the cash investment or whatever right away. So should I be on the phone? I'm sorry?
It's not serious.
It's not serious, doesn't have the motivation, doesn't have the authority, doesn't have the money. It's not a timely, it's not the good right time to do this. Doesn't have the character to keep her word. That's qualification, isn't it? When should we find all that good stuff out? In the beginning, the middle, way in the end?
Yeah.
This is one of the worst mistakes I always made in sales. I get emotionally involved. I answer all their questions. Oh, great question. I answer all their questions because I know the answer. Remember in school when the teacher asked, you did your homework for once and the teacher asked a question. Oh, I know that one. Ooh. Right?
Yeah.
Okay. We're dying to give the answer. But really what we should be doing is there the need? Is there the money to pay for the need? The authority to make a decision and to do it today? This is what goes on in my mind that I want to find out very early on.
Right.
You know, let's imagine for a moment. Go ahead.
No, just a question. So we don't have to show them how much we really know at the very beginning, because what we're trying to find out if they are really serious, so they're really ready to make a commitment today.
Exactly. Here's the rule. You've got to find a need or create a need or exacerbate a need. You've got to find an emotional, you've got to make it emotional. That's why I was talking about Cialdini before. How do we influence somebody? How do we persuade them? How do we hypnotize them to respect us, to pay attention to us? Mm-hmm. Instead of going into that, hold on 1 second here. Oh, sure. People don't pay attention today unless they're emotionally involved, right? You ever see it? You go to a real estate, you go to a seminar and you got a really bore, or a real estate club and you got a really boring speaker. What is every, look around the audience. What are they doing?
Playing on their phone.
Yeah.
So Cloud, so if you disqualify those suspects, do you ever follow up with them? If you do, like how often are you going to follow up with them?
That's a great question. Seriously, that is a great question. What do you think? If they're a 4 or 5, but they don't have the money right now, they're making a decision about a house in probate and they have 2 siblings, but they're not ready to make any decisions or anything like that, but it's a good property, you'd like involved, but they're not ready to do anything today. What do you think you should do?
Pardon?
Follow up.
You mean?
I mean, I was definitely going to follow up with them.
How? Tell me the process.
You know, is any situations changed? You know, like just finding the needs and motivation more, you know, since the last time we spoke, you know, just to go to that angle to find out that. I don't know exactly, but that's why I'm asking, because right now, the only thing I think you're saying, like, you qualify, disqualify, and then they just kind of, you know, but then I just don't think I ever heard anything you mentioned about follow up on the people that you did.
Can you guys see my screen?
Yes.
Yeah.
So if I call retreat, say again, Suzette.
Is that what we're going to do, our guts retreat next time?
It's in Rancho Santa Fe. It's beautiful. But if I get a property and I'm not ready to do a deal, can I put it in Evernote up here?
Yeah.
I'll put it in Evernote. Here's my reminder. Gee, I want to talk to them on Sunday at 10 o'clock and set it. And I have all my notes here. Offer 1.9. It's got a 3.2 mil value. Take a 1.5 note. Oh, it's Tom and Margaret Smythe. Okay, if I got all my notes here, will that remind, should you, so to answer your question, Yiming, save your notes. I write them down, pen and paper. I'll take a picture. I'll take the link from Zillow. I'll write in my notes. I'll do an audio file, a video file, and I will hit the reminder. Because you can't remember all this stuff. This is how you stay organized. But I'm a KISS method guy. I don't want to get a Podio or one of these systems. I don't want applications that take me 2 weeks of seminars to learn how to use. And that's why I love Evernote. It's simple. That's why I recommend simple applications because they work. How much time do we waste on applications and things like that? You know, FreedomSoft, all these things. Dude, the learning curves are forever on these things. The only thing I want to know, the only thing I, all my business, all my organization, everything I do, everything I do is to get me back on the phone or Zoom or a one-on-one with somebody to renegotiate. But I want to have all my notes and information ready. And then we play that role, just to summarize, because I have to leave. We play that role, the $5 million role, right? Mm-hmm. How would you act in many situations? You're still nice people, you're good people, you're ethical people, but would you act differently if you had millions of dollars tax-free in your bank account today?
Yeah.
Do you think you'd act differently in negotiation?
You'd always think I've made a decision.
How powerful, it's up to you. How powerful is that in communicating to a prospect, in the buying, selling, whatever? What kind of message do you send to somebody when you know you're successful already, you're financially secure? What is the vibe, the message you're giving out?
That you're successful and you don't need to take any bullcrap from anybody.
Yeah, you need me. I'm already there. Mm-hmm. What goes through the mind of the prospect? Huh? Hello there.
Hi, Claudia. How are you?
I'm good. Hi, guys.
Hello.
I heard your voice, so I had to say hi to you, girl.
Yes. Great to see you.
We're going wining today?
Yes, we're going to our favorite winery this afternoon.
Wining?
Yeah, he wines all the time, but we're going to go to a winery. Yeah. Yes.
This is the greatest thing about a business.
Yiming, you know where Orfila is?
We've had this conversation.
Oh, you did? Oh, okay.
He's never been there.
Oh, my.
I'm going to check it out, you know.
You've got to go. You take the North County Fair exit off of Route 15, and you head towards the Wild Animal Park.
Okay.
See a bunch of roses. That's where the winery is.
Where do you live? Fallbrook?
Scripps Ranch.
Scripps Ranch. Yeah, so you know.
Oh my gosh, you're minutes away. You got to go.
Yeah, I will. I will definitely.
We'll take them to Blue Water.
Oh well, that's next time I got to go.
Yeah, and about next time I'm out when this COVID bullshit is gone, I'm throwing a party.
Yes.
Yes.
Yeah. Oh, man. I want to get back to normal again. How about you? How important is our attitude? You know, just what's going on in the mind of a prospect when we act like the traditional, what we do with everybody. Oh, hi, how are you? I'm here to help you answer all your questions. La, la, la. What's going through their mind?
Here we go again.
You know, here we go again. Same old and everything. When you say, hey, listen, I got a room full of patients here. I've got, you know, I'm so busy here. I'm glad to see you, but we've got to cut to the chase here. Why are you here? How do you feel? Where does it hurt? Okay. This is your big takeaway. This is one of the best things I do with people. When I say, I've made a decision. What have I taken away from the prospect when I say this?
Decision making.
Their doubt.
They don't got a chance to make the decision. You already made decision for them.
You're not allowed to think about it. Yeah. You're not allowed to think about it. What do you mean? You came to me with a problem. I'm giving you a solution. You can tell me to get lost or imagine for a moment. Then I go into guts 2.0. Imagine for a moment you bought a house, you sell a house, you're getting 18% return on your money. The problem is gone. You know, boom, and you use those five senses and you paint a picture in their mind. I've made a decision. We're going to fix this problem today, or you can tell me to get lost and I'm out of here. But the problem still remains and you'll have a lot of regret. I've made my decision. What about you, Christian?
Yeah, Claude. I mean, if this is going to solve my problem, then I think we should just.
It will solve your problem. And what do you mean think?
Well,
I've got to get going. I've got a lot of places to go, a lot of things to do. I've got a closing and everything. You came to me. Do you want to think about it? Or are you ready to make a decision? This is about making decisions. I've already made mine. Do you want this problem to remain and screw around with this, or do you want to solve it now?
No, I want to solve this, Claude. Let's do this.
What?
Let's do this.
Oh, it's over. Yep. That's it. Then you can go into the intellectual. You can take care of the money, the timing, and everything like that. And then you do your post-sell. We'll talk about that at another entourage, okay?
Awesome.
Well, before you go, I had one question about.
No, I gotta go, man. Real quick, 30 seconds question. Go ahead.
Would you, when she changed the subject, would you go back and grill to get an answer for that question?
Yeah.
How would you do that?
Suzette, I'd love to answer your question, but you never answered mine. And it leads me to believe that there's a problem here. I asked you very straightforward, what's your liquidity and your resources and decision-making capabilities if you found the right property that gave you the return you're looking for? Could you share that with me before we move on, please?
Yes.
And then you listen. Is she going to, what about the speed of the reply? How important is that? If Suzette takes that long pregnant pause, what does that tell you? Or she changes the subject and obfuscates again. What does that tell you right away?
You're done.
It's over. Mm. She has no money, no resources, no authority. You're wasting your time.
Mm.
Okay. How much, you know, you don't want to, millionaire thinking is not wasting your God-given natural organic resources. I sounded like a millennial there, didn't I? I said the word organic. I should have thrown a couple transparents in there or what's the other one? I want an authentic answer.
You're going to share
do it this proactively.
Yeah. I'm sorry.
You're going to share this recording in Skype?
I could do that. Okay.
Okay. Sure. Great.
Yeah, I will. I got to go, guys. It's a day.
All right. All right.
Thank you. Fun. Enjoying the whining.
I will. See you later. Good.
Yeah, take some picture for us.
Really good. Okay. I'll do that. See you later.
Take care.
Enjoy the weekend.
Good session.